Hi there, I'm Sophina and welcome to my channel. So recently I was thinking it's about time that I upgrade my pot and stove system for backpacking. But before I upgrade, I want to really make sure that whatever I'm upgrading to is gonna be worth it in terms of the time it takes to boil water and also the amount of fuel it's going to take. So it's time for a head-to-head gear comparison. Right now I'm using this aluminum pot with the MSR pocket rocket, and that's working pretty well, but I think we can get a little bit more efficient than that. So today we're gonna test this system against the Jetboil Flash and the MSR Windburner. And so these two pots are supposed to be able to capture heat more efficiently. So if you see on the bottom of these pots, they have ridges which are supposed to allow them to capture the heat and in theory boil the water faster and using less fuel. So today we're going to test three different things. How long does it take each of these systems to boil 500 mils of water? How much fuel does that take? And do these pots really matter? Are the pots the more efficient part of this system? Or is it really the stove? Or are they not more efficient? Let's get into it. Okay, so here's our experimental plan. First, we're going to weigh our fuel canister to determine how much fuel we're starting with. Then we're going to add 500 mils of water to the pot. Assemble the stove onto the fuel canister. Light the stove and turn it up to max. Place the pot on top and start the timer. I stopped the timer when the water came to a full rolling boil, as you see here. Then I removed the stove and reweighed the fuel canister to determine how much fuel was used to boil the water. These five steps were then repeated with the Jetboil Flash and the aluminum pot with the MSR pocket rocket. And with all good experiments, I then repeated this three times for each pot. If you test once, it's just an observation, twice is a trend, and three times, now you can do statistics. So let's take a look at our results. Since we repeated the tests three times, we can do statistics on it to determine if the differences that we see are significant. If the differences are significant, we can conclude one stove system is better than the other. So first, let's look at how long it took to boil water in ideal conditions, so inside with no wind. The Jetboil on average took 1 minute and 43 seconds to boil. The Windburner took 2 minutes and 20 seconds, and the aluminum pot on the pocket rocket took 3 minutes and 13 seconds. Both the Windburner and the Jetboil were significantly faster than the aluminum pot, and the Jetboil was significantly faster than the Windburner by 37 seconds. Looking at the fuel required to boil, the only significant difference was between the Jetboil, which used on average 5.3 grams, and the aluminum pot and pocket rocket, which used 6.7 grams. There was no difference between the Jetboil and the Windburner. So under ideal conditions, the Jetboil and the Windburner outperformed the pocket rocket and aluminum pot in time to boil. And the Jetboil was the fastest using a similar amount of fuel as the Windburner. With that said, no one goes camping in ideal conditions, and there is usually some wind involved. So let's test how these stove systems do when we introduce wind. To test each stove system in windy conditions, I used my Vornado on the lowest setting and tied strings to it so you could get a sense for how strong this is. It was similar to a windy day at camp, and this would be as if you had no way to shield your stove from the wind. I measured 1 foot away from the fan and marked it so that all the pots were placed in the same spot. And once I got the stove lit, turned up to max, and the pot on top, I started the fan and the timer.
Thank you.
Looking at time to boil, the Jetboil took on average 3 minutes and 26 seconds. The Windburner took 2 minutes and 33 seconds, and the aluminum pot, after 20 minutes, did not boil. So the wind was too much for the pocket rocket and the aluminum pot to boil in a reasonable amount of time. And this has been my experience. So if there's a lot of wind, it'll take it around 15 minutes to boil water, but we have to make sure we're shielding it from the wind, at least a little bit. The Windburner did live up to its name and was significantly faster than the Jetboil by 53 seconds. And it only took 13 seconds longer to boil water in windy conditions compared to ideal conditions, which is pretty impressive. The Jetboil, on the other hand, took twice as long to boil compared to ideal conditions. Looking at the fuel required to boil the water, the Jetboil took on average 9.3 grams, while the Windburner took 6.7 grams. However, while this difference came close, it did not reach statistical significance. So the Jetboil and Windburner are both faster in time to boil than the aluminum pot in ideal and windy conditions. But is it the pots themselves or the pot and stove systems that make the difference? Now to our last test. Are the Jetboil and Windburner pots more efficient at boiling water than just your regular old aluminum pot? To test this, we use the pocket rocket to boil water with these two pots under ideal conditions and compared it to the aluminum pot results that we got previously. So let's take a look at the results. Looking at the time to boil, the Jetboil took on average 2 minutes and 26 seconds, the Windburner took 2 minutes and 49 seconds, and the aluminum pot took 3 minutes and 13 seconds. The Jetboil and Windburner pots were both faster than the aluminum pot, so the pots do make a difference and are more efficient at capturing heat. And again, under these ideal conditions, the Jetboil is faster than the Windburner. When we look at fuel to boil, the only difference was between the Jetboil and the aluminum pot. While the Jetboil and Windburner pots were still more efficient at boiling water on their own, both did take longer to boil on the pocket rocket compared to on their stoves. So it is both the pot and the stove combinations that make these systems most efficient. So our conclusions are that either system will be more efficient than the aluminum pot and pocket rocket setup that I have right now. The Jetboil is the fastest at boiling water under ideal conditions, but if you introduce wind as a factor, the Windburner outperforms the Jetboil. There was no difference in the fuel used between the Jetboil and the Windburner in either ideal or windy conditions, and the pot does matter, but it's the pot plus the stove that will give you the best results. I have been camping in some crazy wind, and it would be nice to not worry about it affecting my ability to cook food. So I'm leaning towards the Windburner. But what about you? Which one would you go with? Or if you have one of these, let me know what your experience has been. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to see more head-to-head gear tests and backpacking trips. All right, until next time, I'll see you on the trail.